If you have one of these old film 35 millimeters point and shoot cameras, or maybe an older model from the 80s, and just put a roll in it, shoot a few pictures, and bam, the camera goes dead. It's not the battery, it's really the camera has failed. Here's how to try to retrieve the film inside without exposing it and without losing the pictures you already did. Absolutely, logically, you need to be in the very, very dark room. I recommend maybe a bathroom without windows at night, and we just open the camera. Inside the film, obviously this side are the pictures that you already did, so it's a little bit of roll in there. Just remove the film and work gently anyhow, just don't force on the gears here, because who knows, maybe you will repair the camera one day. Grab the film in complete darkness and then do this kind of move. Try to just pull on it a little bit and push it back a little bit. Do not force on the well, just try to move it like this, and at same time try to go farther away. So do this movement. It may or may not work. Don't force, don't go too fast, just keep going like this, and at some point, perhaps with a little bit luck, you will pull all the film from there. Don't forget to roll it back inside the canister, so you don't want to expose it again to light in any way. Not red light, not any tiniest light in the room at all. You may just put it, roll it all the way back and bring it to the photo lab. That's it. And by the way, this is you can buy this new, just check photo stores in the city, give them a call maybe, or check their websites. They are still selling this either Kodak Gold, mostly Kodak ones, in the cheap one films, but they also have more professional. So you don't need to buy expired films from eBay or some other place like that. Just really call local stores and like the specialty stores, and just ask them if they have theirs. Not so expensive. This one gold is actually, back in the day, was a one of the cheapest one you can get. Gold 400, 200, 100. You also have these days Max something Kodak, and these are actually not that bad films. If you check online, there's even hobbyist photographic guys who will tell you that these films actually have been developed for a very, very long time back in the days, so they have reached maturity in the colors, contrasts, and so on. So it's a still good options today. You don't have to fork $15 for a, or $20-$25 for a professional film. These sell for maybe $6-$7 US Canadian, and they are worth trying. I would recommend this one, Gold 200 and Color Max, I think is the second one which I tried, and give them a try.